I'll do a basic mix on the monitors and we'll adjust it after your first song. So I'll get kind of what should be in a monitor that you'll be able to get through a song with.
Thank you.
Easy as.
Here we go. Found one. Are we kicking off now? Hey, bro. I think we're good to kick off. Yeah.
Is this all good? Right here?
Sweet. Yeah, don't point your mic down, bro. Just keep it up, yeah.
Sure. Okay, thank you for that. Yeah, share my work. I like your pants. Yeah. Oh, right. Topu topu tū ki te rangi, ka puta ki te whai au, ki te au marama, tī hei mauri ora. E ngā mana, e ngā reo, e ngā mātā waka, nei te mihi ki a koutou katoa, ko hara mai nei, ki te whakanui i tēnei kaupapa. Ara, tō tātou tīna ranga tīratanga, te reo atu i Waitangi, te rā i tuku ngā mea, I runga I te pepa, engari, you know, he whawhai no tātou, engari kau ewe I whare ki rungi I tēnā. I just want to say welcome everyone to a beautiful day in Dunedin. I just want to quickly introduce myself. My name is Harlam. I was born and bred in Dunedin. My links are to Kahununu ki Wairarapa, and then also to Whānau ki Pōtaka ki Hawaii, and whakawhiti atu ki te moana nui a kiwa ki a hāmoa hoki. So big acknowledgement to my iwis and everyone here that have come through. So I'll just pass you over to my co-host.
Kia ora e te iwi. No mai haere mai to Waitangi Day Festival here in Utiputi. Ko wai au, ko Missy Parata toku ingoa. So my name is Missy Parata, and I was born here in Dunedin and raised away, but now I'm back and I live in Karatani. Coming to town today to get some more water and hang out with you guys and have a really good day of celebrating heaps of years of having a nice partnership and everything. Here's Harlam.
So we're your MCs for today. Really appreciate everyone coming out to celebrate the kaupapa. You know, we just want to give a health and safety warning before we start our event. As you can see, there's those Q cards, things that have been that you need to scan in. We encourage everyone to do it. Whatever your stance is on it, please just do it so that, you know, you're not putting anyone else in risk, and that way we can make sure we're all having a good time. So if you can see them around, make sure you scan yourself in, and, yeah, let's have a good time. Yeah, ka tuki ngā mihi ki, ki tō tātou nei kaihanga I te tuatahi. Ara, ka hori atu au ki tō tātou nei to our guest, to our deputy mayor. But I just want to say, I'll just give a karakia for the day, and then I'll pass it over to our deputy mayor. To our deputy mayor. Ka pai? Yo, ka pai. All right. Tū tau mai I runga, tū tau mai I raro, tū tau mai I roto, tū tau mai I waho, kia tau te mauri tū, te mauri ora, kia tātou katoa. Tūturu whiti whakamaua kia tīnā.
Okay, everyone, we're going to welcome to the stage our Deputy Mayor, Christine Gary.
Tēnā koutou katoa, rei hui hui mai nei. Ena mana, ena reo, ero rakatera mā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. It is my pleasure as Deputy Mayor of Otapulti Dunedin to welcome you here on behalf of the city. Whether you're here in person, in the centre of our beautiful city, or joining us via internet streaming, tēnā koutou katoa. Waitangi Day is a special day for Aotearoa New Zealand and for Otapulti Dunedin. It's an opportunity to celebrate the signing of Tia Tiriti and to acknowledge the concept of partnership it brought to the founding of our country. Yes, there are discussions and debate to be had around instances where the government and the Crown have failed to keep promises made. But for me, today is about celebrating the successes of the past while we look forward to a better future. By the time of the signing of the Treaty of Waitangi in 1840, the people of Dunedin and the mana whenua of Otapulti and the surrounding areas were well versed in developing partnerships. The first European sealers and whalers to make their way here were welcomed and helped in their endeavours by tangata whenua who firmly believed in aroha ki te tangata, a love for all people. This was the foundation for another important belief, that of manaakitanga, or hospitality, welcoming people and ensuring their needs are looked after. Kaitahu went on to demonstrate this to an even greater extent when the first settlers from the John Wycliffe and Philip Lang arrived by supplying fish, potatoes and other food while the settlement of Dunedin established itself. It is widely accepted that many of those Scottish settlers would not have survived without that manaakitanga. My understanding is that manaakitanga promotes inclusion, diversity, making sure the well-being of people is at the front of mind. It is a concept all cultures can learn from, and one I would like to think underpins our city and feeds into our whanaakitaka community spirit. I would like to acknowledge our mana whenua and all they have done over the past 200 years or so to welcome and care for those who have followed. Today is another opportunity to celebrate our city's growing diversity and the many cultures that now contribute to the Dunedin community. It is my great hope that those who come to our city as visitors or new residents feel its warm embrace. From the arrival of the first people to these shores hundreds of years ago, and through the generations and the many cultures and people who have followed, The first thing we were all looking for was paradise, and I believe we found it. And I think in the years now, we were in a global pandemic, we are lucky. We consider ourselves so lucky and fortunate. And it's a timely reminder of that. And I just want to reiterate that scanning of the QR codes, folks, because aren't we lucky to be able to gather as people in far-flung places cannot right now. Today, as well as celebrating the past, we should also look to the future and building on partnerships old and new. At the moment, the Dunedin City Council is working on its 10-year plan, which carries this theme, the future of us. And it reminds me of the beautiful Ngāi Tahu Whakatokio proverb, which goes, Mōtātou a mōka uria muri ake nei. For us and our children after us. Kia ora.
Thank you. Okay, we're all going to sing the national anthem now. So, Etu, please stand up and we'll do it together. Oh, I'm not going to sing on the microphone. We've got a really good singer going to sing on the microphone.
All right. Hey, oh, to O nai wimatora ata whakarongona e aroa noa ia hua ko te pai ki a tatoa ta whai mana ki tia mai a te aroa God of nations at thy feet in the bonds of love we meet hear our voices we entreat God defend our free land God Pacific's triple star from the shafts of strife and war make our praises heard afar. God defend New Zealand.
Thank you.
Oh, shit. Oh, my pocket book and what did they Who knew? We got some amazing talents in Dunedin. I think you have a see Whānau. Yeah, just as I was reading over the things, so on today's list, we have we got Molly and Maddy coming up in a couple of minutes to do some more waitas for us, and then after that, we're gonna have some spot prizes after that. So every performance, we're gonna have another spot prize so that we know that the message of Waitangi Day is going out there in the community. So and then after that, we got David Eggleton and Richard Wells. Yeah, oh man, I'm not good on names, for I know, so, you know. And then we'll finish off with the Black Sail House, which was just doing their sound check for stuff. But, yeah, ngā mihi nui kia koutou. Ko te mea nui, ko haramai nei rungi te rangi Māori o tō tātou nei kaihanga. Kia pai tō koutou rā. I'm going to hand it over to Missy to do some more stuff for you guys. Kia ora.
Hey, okay. I got a question. It's a prize, by the way. So if you want a prize, you got to give me the answer. Okay. So it is. Okay. Where are the 9 sheets of Te Tiri o Waitangi? So the Treaty of Waitangi held now. Anyone? Where? Put your hand up. Do you want to come up here? Huh? The museum? The museum? Oh, okay. Let's see what you have to say. My bad. I think I broke it. Wait. No, I didn't. Never mind. Sorry, guys. Sorry about that. Okay. What's your answer?
National Archives.
National Archives. Oh, okay. Let me just have a look. You're correct. Oh, yeah. Everyone, round of applause. You got the right answer. So it's in the National New Zealand Archives. That's where they are. And I'm just going to give her prize.
So you know, the ones that get photocopies are not the real ones, Whānau. So don't think you've got the real one hanging on your wall. But yeah, to reiterate, it is at the National Archives, all nine of our treaty. And that is just a promise between Pākehās and Māoris to live together as one. But, you know, he rarua no tēnā, he rā no tātou. You know, that's your guys' research. But as for now, I think our band, I'm looking down. Okay, sorry, we got another prize giving then. At the whānau, okay. Can anyone out of all the 500 iwis who did not sign the Treaty of Waitangi? Anyone who did not sign the Treaty of Waitangi? Out of 500 iwis? Yeah, you good, sir?
Did you say Ngāti Kuri?
We need an iwi. We need an iwi base. Anyone else? Yeah, over there, good sir. Did you say tuhui? Oh, bro. Nawe. Ai, tika tēnā. So, tuhui is one of the many iwis that did not sign the treaty. What? Come up, boy, grab your prize, bro. Come on, grab a prize, bro. So, yes, whānau. This year, as we're trying to get rid of those generic questions about the Treaty of Waitangi. It's time to go deeper into that now. It's time to figure out how we as a people can uphold and whakamana the Treaty of Waitangi for everyone. So, yes, Tuhoe was one of the people, one of the iwis that did not sign it. And they have fought for their tino ranga tiratanga since then. So, yeah, mihi atu ki a koe, bro. Nice. That was a good one. Any other questions?
I got one more. It's broken again. Did it break? I think it's broken. Oh, no, it's working. Okay. All right, I got one more question. How many women signed the Treaty of Waitangi? Anyone? Any women signed the Treaty of Waitangi? Yeah? How many? How many? None? Oh, Carl. So there was some that signed the treaty, just how many? Yeah? One? Oh, Carl. How many?
Five.
Five? Oh, Carl.
Five?
Carl.
Oh, come on, five.
Keep going up. How many? 13.
Correct.
Well done. So it's a 13. 13 women signed the treaty.
So just so you know, whānau, males were the only ones that were leading their iwi or their hapū. Most of the time it will come down to the wahine because our men will go off to war and fight each other. So the wahine hold the mana of the tribe in terms of the whakapapa and getting it, bringing it down to the people. So yeah, you'll find out that there's quite a few wahines that have signed it, and under British law, they don't acknowledge women as holding power. But to us, as te reo Māori e tangata whenua, the women hold more rights than some of our male counterparts. So yeah, if we didn't have our women, we wouldn't be here today. So that's the basics of te reo Māori. So you know, ki tā te wahine, ki tā te tāna, tāne he mana no tāna. So yeah, so just as we're getting ready, I'm just going to quickly ask. Okay. We're just going to keep one more prize, whānau. It's just because technical difficulties are coming up. But is there another question?
Yep.
There is. Yep, Missy's got our next question. Any more? Do you know one? How many months did it take to capture all 544 rangatira signature upon the 9 sheets of the Treaty of Waitangi? How many months, whānau? I'll give you a clue. It's more than one. Weeks, anyway. Yeah, kei ako e. No. How many? How many months? Yeah, how many months? Say it. No. Call. Come on, whānau. Remember, we're on horsebacks and we're on boats. No. Call. Oh. No. Call. No, Carl. Yeah, I did, but I couldn't find them. Oh. Yeah. Carl. Tata. Tata. Yeah. Eight. What did you say for? How much? One up. Eight. Yeah, couple up, bro. There we go. So whānau, okay, look, I heard someone say eight before and I couldn't find them. Okay, come on, grab a price thing. So it took 8 months, whānau, so you got to remember, this is horseback riding back in the day. This ain't no jump in your car, pull up the gas and we're there in a couple of hours. This is go from each iwi to each iwi and then you gotta cross that. You gotta cross that. The one or two to get from the North Island to the South Island. So, you know, took 8 months for all of those signatures to get done, and you could see that, you know, some of it could be damaged due to erosion and the ships and all that sort of stuff. And some of them missing. Some of them selling them. You know, all that sort of stuff happens. So yeah, as we celebrate this day, we also remember those that have passed on as well, that have upheld the mana motu hake of all of us. You know, whether we're allowed in our DCC buildings, where we're allowed in our parliaments, where we're allowed to be police officers, where we're allowed to be anything we really want to be. So those are the whawhais that our tūpunas are for, so that everyone has the right to do those, regardless of the skin colour and regardless of the creed. So e te iwi, I think that's it. I think you're sick of hearing me. So I'll let Missy introduce this band.
Okay, so they've just got a couple more touches to do, and then they're going to blow you away with their talent. So do you have a... All right. Are you ready?
Oh, no, sorry. A few more minutes.
Oh, they've got a few more minutes. That's okay. That's all right.
We can chuck some background music on for you if you want, Missy. We can put background music on for you.
Yeah, that'd be really good. Oh, background music. Woo, yep.
If you want, we could talk about what we're going to do while I'm...
Feel boy, baby, do a leap and make them dance when they come on. Everybody looking for...
We've got some background music because we do. Just talk amongst yourselves, socialise, you know, people's tato. Maybe go grab some food.
Now Titi, ke haere atu koe, me mato ke a ke aho, ko te ra ke runga ko au ke raro, ka tutu ki tā wā, ano ne ko koe toku moana, puti a ke kei toro mi au, tu kua hau, ko koe te tino take. Te tai a te aha, te harato ne I tō iwa, ki atu o ki a koe ka ore I tika, te matai a koe, ngā mea whai tikanga, kia maringi mai te waha, koe e kera ki te ki atu, ki a koe e pono ana. I huri rapa e tōku a E tipu nei te pōka kuta ke o ana au Wana kore ana Ko hiri ka pō ki tēnā kau Te arora me aha inai ane Kua kawa ki a reka Te ahi ahi
your patience. My name's Molly Devine. I'm so excited to be here. This is my beautiful friend Maddy. She's so awesome. Thank you for the honor of singing the national anthem. That was a really beautiful surprise for a Saturday morning. Our first song is called Shades of Blue. It's a new song. You run through me That song's called Shades of Blue. This next one's called The Sculptor. It's about time.
I watched a boy mold his fortress on a seashell's backward shore. Willing and chiseling his fingers as the cold blue ocean, and the ocean hummed its tallest tune under the words of an indifferent moon, and the golden sun caressed the dunes. The fading light made me think of you, and the dying and
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. If you've just arrived, welcome to Waitangi Whānau Day here in the Octagon, where the gods have really put it on for us, which is fabulous. It's quite nice because it's warm, but not like, oh, stifling. Maddy likes, that's her favourite kind of weather. It's really good. So big thank you to everybody who's put this event together. Whoever organised those little grass seat things, big thank you to you. They're fabulous. And gravity events, they're always amazing, amazing, amazing. I know Vicky, wherever she is, where's Vicky? Not sure, but she was like the head honcho, so she's so amazing. And Hayden and Missy are MCs. And then later up, we've got the wonderful Black Sail House, who is going to play for us. That's all very exciting. This next song is called Someone Like You. I was very fortunate in 2019. This was Dunedin's favourite radio station, Radio 1's 11th most played song. It was 11th? Yeah, I think it was the 11th most played song. So that was very exciting for us, very exciting. So big thank you to Radio 1 and Dunedin for, you know, enjoying this song. So I hope we can all enjoy it today. It's called Someone Like You, and it's about meeting someone on the dance floor and being like, you're right.
I can see you in the flashing lights. Did you come alone tonight? I catch you. So many faces, but I want you. But I'm gonna give someone like you. Yeah, I'm gonna give someone like you. And I can take my eyes off you and don't wanna be alone. Oh.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, I'm not sure how much longer we are going to be playing for, but we've got a few more songs. Can't see. So this next one requires dancers. And, oh, no, I forgot to bring my dancers. Oh, no, what a shame. So if anybody in the audience, two more songs, we can do that. So if any, you're a dancer, please come forward to the dancing area. Any dancers who want to come, all ages are allowed to be in the dancers. If anybody wants to come in. Well, we've got two really good dancers. And you can do the dance moves from wherever you are if you don't want to join the dancing space. All right, I'll just get it all ready and then we can learn the moves. So this song's called Call Me Up, and there's a music video for this one filmed in Glenorchy, and we had some really awesome dancers that made these moves for us that we get to do today. Okay, so we'll just... What I'm going to do, I'm just going to teach them to you, and then we'll start the song. So the first one is like this. Yeah? Like that. That's it. And then like this. I like the face. The face is really good, actually. That's working for me. Good. This. So we go. Two. Yeah, another dancer has joined. Yeah. So this is our first move. Let's keep this pumping for a little bit. Yeah. Is that feeling good? And the next move is really similar. But we just sort of, like, we can make a sound. So we go. This is da 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 da. Don't we go da 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 da. Yeah, good, good, good. I like it. And then we do four of these. This one's like a little bit sassy, so you got to get real sassy. You ready? So maybe the lips. Good, good. So that's gonna go. How does that one go? Oh, I'll have to do it all in context. Here we go. So from the top, ready? This is it. Let me go. Huh? Ba da ba da ba ba. Huh? Ba da ba da ba ba. Do the face. Da 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 da. Da da da. Yeah, that's it. So you guys ready? So that comes in the chorus. If anybody wants to film this, that would be amazing. I would love that. I'd love that. All right, so this song's called Call Me Up. And it's about, like, some babe calls you on the phone. You're like, oh, my God. I'll tell you when to start dancing, yeah? I never knew what I was missing. We freestyle on a bit. Till you came into my world. Every moment's got me wishing, oh.
Can't believe you wanna leave.
guys ready?
When I'm alone, you're where I want to. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I never thought that I would be the one you need. And I never thought you'd be thinking of me. And I never thought that I would be the one you need. And I never thought you'd be thinking of me.
Freestyle! Woo!
I can't believe you want me, yeah. No, I can't.
Oh my gosh, you guys. You're hired. That was amazing. Thank you. You've been practicing your whole life. That's incredible. Am I famous? Well, no, I'm not. But yes, I am. You can think I'm famous. That's good. Thank you guys so much. That was so fab. Would you mind getting a photo of my amazing dance crew? Yeah, this is Martine. If we could look at Martine. Amazing dance crew crowd around. We should do like a dancer's pose. I feel like dancers do stuff like this. Yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. Thank you all so much. Thank you. All right, I'm not sure if we've got time for one more because my two songs, the one went quite long. One more? Yeah, cool. Want to do a dancey one?
Yeah.
Bring Me Love. All right, so this song's called Bring Me Love. It's very simply about love.
Said I wanna be alone, and you came, a river of unknown. Oh, I thought I needed space, till I felt your fingers on my waist. You said, talk to me, baby, not just with words. Don't feel ashamed, no, share me your heart. All my life, I thought I had something to hide, but with you I'm diving in.
Devine, this is Maddy Parkins-Craig. We are so grateful to be here for the Waitangi Day, Whānau Day. It's so beautiful to see all of your faces. So thank you so much. I'm going to pass you back over to our wonderful MCs, Missy and Hayden. Oh, thank you for the hugs. You guys are the best. That was so awesome. Thank you.
I moeroa, oiana I te kainga, pūkoro piako, kore kore ko iho ana te rā. Takato anei moingake, katahi tonu katutaki, rangirua ko ngā mahara. Oho mai hoki koe, I tōku tā I tōna, nā te hawaia kore ana, tōku ingoa e mū. Pehera te moero, te aro I hera o, a e pai ana. Ina pō,
anō e te tahi, ina Homai te piki paki anō mātou whānau for this wonderful, these two wonderful ladies that perform for us today. It's a bit nerve-wracking sometimes performing in the audience, but she just let us know that she's performing a Waitati tomorrow. So if you want to see her again, make your way out there. So yeah, ngā mihi nui kia koutou. Ngā mihi nui anō to the new faces that are coming, no mā haru mai to the celebration of Waitangi Day, Whānau Day. And as we are coming into the afternoon, my other co-host has just gone to go do some writing before she comes back, but anyway, yeah, as we're sort of just moving on to the next performance, I just want to make sure that you guys are scanning your QR code things. Make sure you guys are scanning in, and also just be wary that the outer ring of the Octagon, there's traffic, so we just want to mind our children going out on our road. And also, there's water in that fountain down at the back, so we just don't want any tamarikis falling in there if they don't know how to swim. So just be mindful. We'll just have a quick break, whānau. Well, I'll just wait for my other co-worker. If we can get some background music, that'll be great.
Koe te mana, ka aha koe, ka kahara nei koe, ki te whakahau, ko pārura nei, ka kahurangi, ko ngā kano me mura mura, ki te pakanga kore, ka mamai koe.
Alright, okay, we're back. Okay, hello everyone again. It's me, Missy Parata. We just have a couple of things, some notes, I would say. So first of all, just a reminder that the road around the Octagon is still running, so it's not closed. So make sure that you're just looking after and watching out for tamariki, crossing roads and everything, okay? But the one in the middle, obviously, is closed. And speaking of, we have some really cool stalls down there. So we have Hello Friday. So there's Hello Friday over here. Señorita Osomo is just over here. And then we've got the Dance Kare, which is beside them over there. And then we have Jennifer Duff, which is in the really, really cool caravan over to the right. Yeah, woo! And we also have some really nice food and stuff just behind us. So, yep, definitely go explore and have a look at what they have down there and the food and stuff. Yeah, and also just reminder that the fountain does have water in it, so keeping an eye on our tamariki around the water. And here's Harlam.
Yeah, okay, yeah, cool, kapai. So if you've been told twice, don't need to be told the third time, eh, whānau? So make sure we're keeping ourselves safe as well. Yeah, it's just there's some sunscreen over there too if people are worried about getting sunburned, or, you know, there's some sunscreen over there just by the table, just forgot to mention there. All right, our first prize is up, okay? This one's for the adults, because it says adult pass on here, so it's for those ones that have that have started to think about shaving your head because it's getting a little bit thin on the top. So here it is. Here's our question. Who signed for the Queen of Waitangi? At Waitangi. Anyone? For the adults, come on, whānau. Who signed for the Queen at Waitangi? Oh yeah, here we go, who's there? No, not Thomas Hobson. Aroha mai. Next, anyone? For Pakeke, come on Pakeke, participate. Can't just have our tamariki participate. Anyone? Maybe has a brother, maybe no Google, don't Google that. Over there, and then, Kei Akwe. Kao, no. No, yeah, look, come on. Kapoi, anyone? Yo, Kei Akwe. Kei Akwe. Whoa, yell it out. Cold. No, it's not. Come on, whānau. See, whānau, this is where we have to start questioning what do we actually know about the Treaty of Waitangi. Yeah, nah, kia ora, ane wha, kia ora. So, whānau.
Thank you.
Congratulations. So, William Hobson was the one that signed for the Treaty, for the Queen of, for the Queen. William Hobson was the one that signed for the Queen for Waitangi, and he was only 42 years old. So you can imagine the pressure that he was under to try and keep the peace at the time. Any more? No, that's all good, because we got more prizes. Kapoi, so Missy has another question. For another one for our adults, eh? Because we want our adults to participate so that our tamariki can participate as well. So,
okay, let me just find one. Okay, I got one for you guys. I got one. Okay, when was the Treaty of Waitangi signed? Yes, 1840 is correct. Come on down and collect the prize. It's over there, yeah. All right, Harlem's gonna go with Harlem. Harlem will take you. Two more. Okay. All right. Okay. Hi. If you just follow Harlem just over there. Oh yeah, and also there's sunscreen over there. Okay, when was Waitangi Day first celebrated? Carl, sorry. Come up here.
Nineteenth century.
What year though? What year in the 19th century? Nah. Oh, well done. Correct. Okay. 1934. Come on over. Go over to Harlem. Harlem's got you. Good job. So it was first celebrated in 1934. Woohoo! Right, mingle amongst yourselves. We'll just have a little break.
Titi, ke haere a tu koe, me mato ke a ke aho, ko te ra ke runga ko au ke raro, ka tutu ki ta wā, ano ne ko koe to kumwana, puti a ke ke I toro mi au, tu kua hau, ko koe te tino take, Te tai te aha, te hara tone I tō ingoa Kia tuo, kia koe, ka ore I tika Te mata I a koe, ngā mea whai tikanga Kia maringi mai te waha, koe e kera ki te kia tu Kia koe pono ana E tipu nei te pokaku take o ana au Whana kore ana Ko hiri ka po ki tēnā kau Te arora me aha inai ane Kua kawa kia reka te ahi ahi
Hide it.
Whakakai marihi, āwhina mai ana, whakahau mai ana, ko koe tōku ahine toa. rā te wahine Iaia tōku nā kau Tōku tokatū moana Ki te ana e koe He ara whakaatū mai tō aroha Aha ko ato mama uiau Kai tōku taha koe Tēnā rā koe Kao rei rā waka Aha ko ana pātari Pau kore ana pe aroha Kore kupu ke atu Ka nui taku aroha Tēnā rā koe Kia mohi o mai kore rawa e rawaka
Kia ora no tātou te whānau, Ngami Inui, thank you for waiting. I know it's hard because it's hot and you know, other stuff are going on, but we want to thank you for taking the time to wait for as we get our groups ready. Ngami Inui, kia koutou. Special guest today, whānau, we've got the number one poet in New Zealand, the New Zealand poet laureate. His name is David Eggleton. Hope I said that right. And Richard Wallis. Whānau, this is you know, these people tell story through words and other mediums, so this is a really good opportunity to you know, really prick his brain and actually get our young rangatahis to know that there are other ways to go out there and look at the world through words, through sight. Mā te kōrero, ka hari a te, you know, ka hari a te reo, you know, so all those sort of stuff. So I'm not going to take up too much of your time because, yeah, it's getting a bit wet out there. Please remember, whānau, there's sunscreen over there if you should need some. Don't be shy. So I'll give him over to the man himself, the second best New Zealander in New Zealand, next to the Prime Minister. Please give it up for Mātua David.
Kia ora. Kia ora, thank you very much. Great to be here on these Waitangi Day celebrations in the Octagon this afternoon. I am David Eggleton. I am the current Poet Laureate of Aotearoa New Zealand. This is an honour was bestowed on me in 2019, and my term expires in 2022. So my role as the Poet Laureate is to advocate for poetry on behalf of poets in this country, but also on behalf of people who like poetry and enjoy poetry, and so bring poetry to public places and let people hear the sounds of our own creative writers in the poetry field. So I began at high school as a writing poetry, and I've kind of just kept going. And here I am, years later, I am now the Poet Laureate. So anybody can be Poet Laureate, they just got to keep going for a while and be determined with your writing and have something that you want to write about. So in my case, it's actually about living in this country, Aotearoa, New Zealand. And I like to write about the icons and emblems and symbols of this country. And this is called Heraldry, as my first poem. And it goes like this. Hand upraised beneath a cloak of mist, the colonial goose is cooked and eaten. Triple-chinned wonders soak in thermal springs, and seals bask on Zealandia's sun deck. Loneliest place on loneliest planet, where bees quilting, so pastures silver. Dairy Queen udders burst snowy from Alps, and pine cones cast off await collection. Dip your toe in Marlborough wine lakes, dodge falls of rock climbers out of mountains, read small grain of a given piece of timber, and wad cardboard into rugby ball shapes. Bloodsport jokers, jockey for lunch money, tractor blockade, smokes the beehive out, pre-mixed underages, gate crash, wine bars, and blad of girl races, burls down boulevards, Fox Glacier launches, a hot fridge brand, fine wool clouds, gather fattened lambs, paddock barbed wires bent round in the crown, and urgent hayseeds, G-up race cup steeds, a name that ripples, and red, white, blue, a slippery pill pop from a seething scrum, half freezer pack, half frozen shoulder, and ref's whistle to raffle off a brassy win. Wheat big spards at breakfast. Address their mums. Hip hop stutters through blizzards of abuse. Snowboarding bohunks, neck ickies with glee. And all eyes on screens fix as if held by glue. Heraldry, it's heraldry, New Zealand heraldry. Thank you. Bit of a stutter there myself. So this poem is called The Sound and the Fury. It's a appropriate poem for Waitangi Day because it's about our heritage. Not stony silence and Kiwi back blocks, but quiet rustling of ferrets and stoats, the blether of sheep, the blither of wind, road gangs scraping shovels in 2-4 time, bang bang of settlers throwing up a house, diggers back and forth toss screwball yarns, stock whips crack and bullockies curse, a steam train crosses 65 bridges, old guard swan song hee-haw of Bonassus, while Bob Semple crowed as he rode the land, it seems he failed to catch the royal ear, magpies quaddle oodle ardle wardle doodle, heard as cat bell and dog whistle remix, motivating truck drivers ditto that uptick, bogans cashed up, await gentrification, seeking a personal tutor, an NZ lit, skim and scam, born by budget jet, arrived from Greece to fleece, a crusader caped in silver fern flag, conjures Anne Zachary from an army surplus bag, the gurgle of a politician's liquid voice, signs uncashable checks in front of cameras, with a silver plume of a heron feather, white gold pipeline chugging towards town, irrigator stutter sucking the wellbore dry, bring the sound and fury of Moo Moo Land. Hear the hoofbeats of stampeding herds, be last man standing in a rolling mall, and from deep depression in the Tasman Sea, be rescued by blood of the underdone lamb. It's the sound and the fury, the sound and the fury, the sound and the fury, the sound and the fury. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm going to be joined now by Richie Wallis, who's got some soundtracks on his laptop. This next number is actually about Tapu Maunga. Captain Cook named it as he went sailing past Mount Egmont. We know it better as Mount Taranaki nowadays. And so this is about Taranaki. It's got music by Martin Phillips of the Chills. I was talking to Martin one day and he said he'd be interested in composing some music, so he came up with some music for this particular poem of mine, and it's a poem called Drifting Cone. Under the slowly drifting cone of Taranaki, when evening stretches out from the mountain, the black tresses of its rivers wind me to you. Always I feel the cold fire of your kiss, that frozen fire that scalds my memory still, the elixir of your lips where love fixed it, so that I should taste like tears and rain, your distant indifference smoldering to ash. Distant indifference. Distant indifference. Distant indifference. Drifting cone. Drifting cone. Drifting cone. Drifting cone. Drifting cone. Drifting cone. Remember the scent of ferns, you are knotted. The crystal haze of mist, whitely shimmering, shimmering, shimmering on the sea swell of your bare, salty flank. The mane of night on your shoulders of snow. And the rare minerals of your eyes that flashed. Your distant indifference smoldering to ash. Your distant indifference smoldering to ash. Distant indifference. Ash. Ash. There you go, Drifting Cone, music by Martin Fulham. I write about living in Aotearoa, and one of our amazing landscapes is the Mackenzie Country. It's actually been named after a sheep rustler called James Mackenzie. I'd like to imagine him as a shape-shifting figure who still inhabits that special landscape of the Mackenzie Country. And I imagine him as a sort of like the nor'west wind. This is called Old Man Nor'wester. It has music by Richard Wallis. Sometimes old man nor'wester blows and so exhumes amidst dust moving, shingles skating, braids shifting, the rain shadow shape of sheep rustler James Mackenzie, who strolled dead broke and crook to boot, only to fluke a landscape he wrapped up tight and carried like a swag, taking 7-league strides across the Mackenzie Country, preaching sermons in Gaelic to his dog as skinks lay hidden like shrunken dragons amongst rocks of subalpine basins, furrowed back to basics by that wind. Tufts of wool chasing across the barrel vault blue vastness of the sky. Mackenzie, though, vanished beyond lost cairn markers long ago. His straggly beard legacy of wilding pines, ragwort, Yorkshire fog, yarrow, gorse, king devil, mouse-eared hawkweed, a rogue's gallery gathering in our sanctum sanctorum of ancient lakes and rivers. We will not sandblast back to the past as power lines sow and scullers row
for New Zealand against drag on Rui Taniwha. And Rabbit start from boot falls in this mirror land of desires, rustled for subdivisions, hydroelectric dams, boating the remains of film sets, dragonfly wheel energies of lakes Tekapo, Pukaki, Ohau, the colour of ground down Punamu, spin into the Waitaki as old man Nor'wester skips dynamic water, flicks it over, rippling sunshine's dismantle of ice into scalding light until the light darkens, pent up, or sings seawards past folded hills seamed with gullies, farmers' corrugated faces, electricity snaking north and south, the fizz of life, and then in the night, those gusts trying to prise open a greenstone door slammed tight on the underworld. Thank you. I was going to say Waitangi down really, this number called Electric Puha Telemarketing Ode. And it's actually one that was composed a while ago. It's about sort of New Zealand in the back in the early 2000s, I suppose. And it's got music to it by Trevor Coleman, who's a well-known jazz musician who formerly lived in Dunedin. He currently lives in Madrid in Spain. But before he left, he composed some music, and this is a backing track now for Electric Puha Telemarketing Ode, and Richard will cue it up, and fire it up, and set it on its way. Straight up! Yes, people! We burn like red meat. Hype to go ape. Disaster wise when what? Your memories of President Cadillac have been retired. Now that wildcat operators have staked out your seat. Goodyear inner tubes on the soles of their shoes. They enter singing the third world debt blues. Poison poppy economists overstuff a hot casino. Pizza vixens buy into the Great Pacific Way. Dive beneath the foam dome of a cold cappuccino. Trip the plastic fantastic like the good old days. Belzebub fires up a humongous giggle stick and plonks himself down in front of the telly. The sizzle of a couch potato turning on a spit is raising hell from beyond the gravy. Like taxi drivers don't break for a backless maxi. False memory syndrome don't fake how it feels. The magazine death mask of Princess Di unpeels from sleep-starved eyes. Caucasian rowdy caucuses who don't look or act Maori take crash courses in bar management for singles, hand clapping to the beat of razor blade jingles. The minister without portfolio wears a flyaway toupee from Sir Robert's hair shirt factory. He's swinging like a soap on a rope champion. Autographs the bestseller, Rivers of Phlegm, and promises airbag flotation to move the nation. Joy Boy and Eco Woman relive their glorious past, pole vaulting to the top of the pantyhose charts. Here's to anonymous supermarket shelf stackers who have no marquee value, so can't find backers for capitalist plots or the state welfare funeral. Spell it out with words of one syllable. Black and blue means I don't love you. Iron guts reads container loads of hate mail in silence, punctuated by gurgles of stomach gas, while the stoned PM telemarkets electric puha from the beehive on wheels, a fast-track racing car to an uncritical ad mass, modelling pimple rash. And don't tell me you don't know who you are. Hurdling thigh master, abdominizer, diet upsetter, smoking your computer under the nuclear umbrella. The poor recycled as clueless, with no agenda. Everyone a worthy cause in search of a soft touch. The sun gun celeb holds a fashion victim pose too much. In Baroque burgeramas, Rococo Cola kids engage in a billion burger binge. From shoe lift to facelift, one triumphant turkey trot. Rat grows human ear, sticky tongue ticky, cerebral cortex rot. Dog's leg cocked against the family tree, blind spot of interchangeable identities. Privatized history, talking electric poo-ha telemarketing old blue. 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 Thank you. Yeah, well, a poet is always looking for that magic word to inspire a germ of an idea. Sometimes I'm looking through the newspaper and I see these advertisements for all kinds of products. Now, this one appeared in a very ancient newspaper. It was a jingle for a patent medicine. It goes like this. I lost two toes in the Mount Cook snows, and an eye in the Tasman Sea, and a hand and a jaw and a circular saw, and a limb and a falling tree. But the pangs untold of a cough or a cold, I know I need never endure, if I moisten my throttle in time from a bottle of Wood's Great Peppermint Cure. So the word I liked there was untold, and that single word, I caught the very faint echo of church bells and horse hooves, Gabriel Reed discovering bright fine gold in central Otago in 1861, and a shovel of dirt shining out like the stars of Orion, as he said. So this is called Untold. Untold those years that rung as gold, like gold poured from a crucible. The yellow lure of sky ablaze, cracked clays, cliff edge crumble. Flung dust in a stinging haze, perfume stealing good as gold. The song of lilies, lupin sun showers, golden kofi, gorse manuka. Gold of root hairs that climb from mud, gold of fern sap bubble from punga. Gold underpinnings in a cloud span, gold's beaten froth that scuds to land. Gold bell chimes a quarter hours. Gold's branch upon branch in rivers, golden bird feathers mottled salt. Gold spills of tobacco leaf makings, gold unreeled and flaked or chipped. Gold the twig, the nest, the thread. Gold the stump, the nub, the chunk. Gold the skin, the lights, gleams pulsing. Gold splinters, dyes, scourings. Gold the broken handled axe head that only yesterday it seems split the fell totara trunk for 500 fence posts and an old man's coffin untold. Untold, 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 untold. The bells of central Otago are ringing out. 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 Untold. Oh, this is about stuff that covers much of New Zealand. It's got a lot to say for itself. It's called Grass. Imagine, if you will,
how this used to be a site for the old Salvation Army Band and the Army Band before that, and back to colonial times. And nowadays, it's us here performing at Waitangi Day. This is called Grass. Shoulders up to the hills, the spirit of great-great-granddad slumps, staring at the sun, his stumps, gnawing fat of the land, side of mutton and hand. The blow-me-down windbreak around his heart, still fit to beat the band. His squatter's hut became a town centre in the now metaphysical bush. Irrational and empirical inheritance of compulsive Methodists. A story sown in seeds of grass and read by generations. From the concrete tree of the sky tower down. The shearers left nothing growing on the sheep's back. Clumps were pulled out gully by gully by golly. Burnt to a frazzle, cleared like throats harumping. Katara ra boom die. Katara ra boom die. Oh, and the rumpty tumpty rhythm track of a colonial militia in full fig. And marching past the band rotunda built on Ruamoko's roly poly belly. As possums acted the giddy goat, harumping, guitarra ra bum die, 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 guitarra ra bum die. Thank you. This is called a bush paddock. Why is it called the bush paddock? Well, in New Zealand iconography, the bush paddock was a place farmers used to have down the backs of their properties, their farms. And there they'd sort of dump stuff they didn't want, didn't need. So it's become like a memorial space in our Aotearoa's national consciousness. So I thought I'd have a go at writing about what I think the bush paddock represents to us. Here today, here this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, the bush paddock. The sharp edges of tourist brochures cut to the quick, slashing away down the back of the bush paddock. King Kumara slithers from a sack of dark earth and begins to propagate his progeny down the back of the bush paddock. Much of Maori Tonga is underwater, and we live amongst its tallest peaks down the back of the bush paddock. Ladies bring a plate of butter pats, or do a terrific pavlova bake, or lather up a froth of rinso flakes down the back of the bush paddock. The graying of the nation sees grannies going for $2 a kilo down the back of the bush paddock. The hydrangeas are flowering in red, white and blue for the royal walkabout down the back of the bush paddock.
Down the back of the
a department store is draped wall to wall, roof to floor with black wool cardigans down the back of the bush paddock. A railway station master raises his flag and
blows his whistle for the Treaty of Waitangi Express. Down the back of the bush pit.
Down the back of the
tribes of possums.
Down the back
come up
the
trumps. A pack of bludgers on the land. Down the back of the bush paddock. A wandering prophet named Pākehā will eat the tongue and eyes of an enemy with the heart of a cabbage tree. Down the back of the bush paddock. Two drongos are trying to build a replica of Mount Ruapehu out of playing cards. Down the back of the bush paddock.
Down the back of the
Victorian outhouses get flogged off at outlandish prices, and sinister garden gnomes lurk in the shrubbery down the back of the bush paddock. The parliamentarian with the head of a kakariki strops his beak on a kowhai tree down the back of the bush paddock. A farm Cinderella
down the back of
and an old sundowner are dancing an armistice jig to a concertina down the back of the bush paddock. Ups a daisy with the old lemon squeezer down the back of the bush paddock. A horned thumbnail dipped in tar strikes a light to standing block, setting fire to the beard of a bard down the back of the bush paddock. Enough posts to prop up the scrum, the mine, the bridge,
down the back of
and build a pub for every man, woman, and child on the west coast
the
are being milled down the back of the bush paddock. Down the back of the bush paddock. Down the back of the bush paddock.
Hey. It's a bit windy up here.
This is called Song of the Market Actor. It's about the great financial crash of 2009. In 2009, everything seemed to go a bit haywire on the stock market, especially over there in the United States, not so much maybe here in New Zealand, where we're a bit cushioned from that. But over there, it was ruthlessness of market forces. We constantly told market forces and the play of a free market are good for us. And how are we told this? We're told this through corporate language. I thought I'd have a go at writing a poem which Richard has set to music about the use of corporate language or slanguage to kind of encourage us to buy things and to believe what we're told by right-wing politicians. A song of the market actor. Can we pick up the numbers, overhaul all front runners? Can we skip on by the velvet rope, memorize the right manner? Can we fool any iris scanner, grease a telltale itchy palm? Can we unearth sacred ancestors, rip out the feather bedding? If I am the market actor, looking for the hidden factor, can we be ground beneath a guru, help to ease those growing pains? Can we trip the wires of persuaders, reveal mounting inner fire? Can we behold our franchise options, slip away the silken bonds? Can we learn how to last a lifetime, appear in the final frame. If I am the market actor, looking for the hidden factor. Can we stay in touch, venture, get more? Push to ultimate levels, then with a single gesture, blow in to chase down windfall. Roseate through sequin night, unforgiving at steel dawn. Yes, till I take on too much. Toxic loss, you're missing funds. So that then come colder rains, screwing over hope for golden years. In the crash of collateral damage, love me, love my emotional bagging. If I am the market actor, looking for the hidden factor. I am the market actor, looking for the hidden factor. Yeah, so I like writing about little things that mean so much to us as people have grown up in this country. And one of the things is that's normally regarded as a bit insignificant, but I think it was a token of remembrance, is the 5-cent piece. You may remember the 5-cent piece. It disappeared. It was the lowest denomination coin in New Zealand currency. It disappeared in 2006. Prior to that, there was the sixpence, which disappeared in 1967. But you know, if when you're a kid, you can buy quite a lot with sixpence or even 5 cents. So it's kind of five jaffers, something like that. This is called the 5-cent coin.
Am I going? 1, 2.
Puddle of silver makes a tumbled host of Tuatara, spun on wooden counters, drop 5-cent coin. Whence the hickapenny, tickapenny, for soap, candles, matches, for the milk, the paper, drop 5-cent coin. When the whole world was the size of a gobstopper, summoned with a rap on a glass top, drop 5-cent coin. Once a carried decimal weight and heft, handed down from sovereigns and crowns, drop 5-cent coin. Bob, copper, ding, electrum, china, tanner, zack, passed on pocket to pocket, drop 5-cent coin.
Handed down.
Legal tender, put money where your mouth is, accounts due, burn holes in pay packets, drop 5-cent coin. It filled a gap. That shiny dot, pitched or tossed, acrobat, stuck to the pavement by chuddy, drop 5-cent coin. Empty husk, a tiddlywink flicked to the end of the line, the breeze light on sun-crinkled water, drop 5-cent coin. Escaping to roll, wobble, travel under corners, spiral once or twice, fall face down, drop 5-cent coin. And still you see it here and there in dust, or else gathered and crammed into a jar for buttons, drop 5-cent coin. Drop 5-cent coin. Drop 5-cent coin.
I just got a couple more numbers to finish up with. This is called Kaifakani, the ventriloquist.
We always play this fast. We've decided to slow it down a bit, see if we can get a bit of a groove going.
Kai Fakani, the ventriloquist. It's sort of about... High-leveled hills for cycleways and walks. I spaded my birthday cake with twisted fork. I clashed over water on the chessboard plane and made navigators of the great canoes. Exchanged their cloaks for crisp white boat shoes. I danced the roaring 40s in gumboot tango. I chomped on mutton fat, I gulped beer for smoko. I bailed up the mob tightly with binder twine. I joined a debt queue by rot gut fortified. I pitched my tent amidst industrial blight. With a weasel's tunnel vision, I watched as godwits trooped down the aisles of jumbo jets. I sacrificed forests for the sake of toothpicks, then played dead for 100 years till a war between ourselves was settled. By game of knucklebones, using the treaty's fist, because I am Kai Fakani, the ventriloquist. I am Kai Fakani, the ventriloquist. I am Kai Fakani, the ventriloquist. And it's all right, John. I'm only dancing to the stop-go tunes of opinion polls. And it's all right, Judith. I'm only dancing to the stop-go tunes of opinion polls. And it's all right, Jacinda. I'm only dancing to the stop-go tunes of opinion polls. Hey. There's a second to last one. It is called Jailbird at Mamona Airport. Hey, karaya rea aho. Yeah, I was looking through the ODT as you do, and I saw this photograph of this private Department of Corrections airplane landed at Mamona Airport, and these shackled felons all got off, and they were all being transported down to the Milton Hilton. So I was quite inspired by this image, a very powerful image. These guys were from Hawke's Bay, and they were being transferred down, and they were making these signs and signals to the photographer. And it set me thinking, and I wrote this, is called Jailbird at Mamona Airport. I come from the Bay of Hawks. Propellers roar my tragedy. I roar my own ecstasy. I'm exiled where I walk. I drool, I hang on my own talk. I'm between jails, coiled in a shroud. I enter shackled at wrist and ankle. My feet are bare, I rankle. I'm off to where I'm sent. But my stare is proud. The howl of the mongrel, the fool's toothless scowl.
I stare at the sun.
My tinny shag paid back. Tinfoil flame and a glass bowl. I drank, I trespass, now I rage. I don't utter sounds of doubt. My rhetoric is renegade. I return to thoughts of Dak. I chew my cheek, I'm made. My toes claw the floor. I am silent as a waiting gun.
Silent as a waiting gun.
Silent as a waiting gun. Silent as a waiting gun. I stare at the sun. I stare at the sun. I stare out of the sun.
Thank you very much. You've been listening to the Poet Laureate, accompanied by Richard Wallis. This is their very last number. It's called Import Export Cultural Recycling. Import Export. Late model import export cultural recycling song.
That's been a mouthful.
It's quite a mouthful. It's actually about one I wrote a little while ago, but import export goes on all the time, and this is kind of about that and more.
And more.
Cherubim of 22 turn into the promises of middle age, locked inside a gilded cage. Jumping jack wetter is growing rhubarb in the suburbs. Academies of yahoos offer diplomas and primal urges. Maybe syringes and razor blades should always gleam inside the translucent plastic loo seats of the scene. The pink parlor poodle of the state has run away to join the great Moscow circus anyway. And all the sacred cows of the status quo just got up and got down with the Orinoco flow. Import, export, import, export, 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 import, export, import, export, import, export, import, export. Rapid eye movement scan, come hither headings of tabloid broadsides and blunderbuss weddings, where Nouveau Woman's Weekly lurks in wait for Anna Horribilis's latest date. A choir of washing machines launches into Purcell Automatic song cycle. Glory be to soap opera, drowning out a brass band rendition, Oompa-pa MMP. Here the new anti-hero is a microwavable couch potato with mobile phone hole star clicked onto a celebrity sizzle turn flammable, while the god boy can't find a tin opener for a gift of pressed tongues from Antarctica. Import, export, import, export, import, export, import, export, import, export, import, export, import,
export, import, export, export.
Death, resurrection, immortality, judgment hall. The warehouse discounts four last things for all and opens a great white elephant stall as jobless, restless mutton chain Joes chow down on pink, bloodless Cheerios. The Archbishop of Otakow takes for sermon strange graffiti written on a dunny cistern. Dole Bludger says, I was here. A government of poets arriving by bicycle is declared, as on penny farthings, glitzocrats and glamazons appear, bringing odes to mutton birds, odes to scones. Come walk a mile in John A. Lee's old boots. Big Cheese announces a zillion ways with kiwi fruits. The ticks giving time with Zurich's money metronomes. The ticks giving time with Zurich's money metronomes. Import, export, 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 import, export.
Thank you very much. That's the Poet Laureate of Aotearoa, accompanied by Richie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Give another round of applause for our performance today. Another round of applause. Kia ora, bro. Thank you for that. I'll come around.
Good to
stop it. Just to make sure you're all getting your sunscreen. Remember the sunscreen's over there. Just making sure that everyone keeps safe while the sun's out. Make sure you go visit the stores as well. The local, for the locals, yeah. Awesome. Remember, number one, next to Prime Minister, you know this fella. Just as we're kind of wrapping up for the day, Whānau, I just want to make sure that you guys are dehydrating. See some drinks down there. Again, you're putting your sunscreen on and the QR code that's around, please make sure you sign in so that we can all be safe, just in case. Our last performance, they're going to come up and set up Black Sail House, a local band, I hope I'm saying this right. Yeah, because, but anyway, Whānau, just want to be here to you guys. Yeah, you made it through to the last bit of performance. Look at the partner next to you, chat, introduce yourself to them, even the one behind you. Waitangi Day is all about celebrating the kotahitanga, not only about individuals, but also as a group. We can all use a bit of, bit of happiness at the moment, considering the year we just had. And, get to know your neighbour, make sure you get to know them and introduce yourself to them. But just want to make sure that everything goes well. Do you? Yeah, she. Don't.
Tēnei te mihi nunui ki a koutou e te whānau e hui hui mai nei ki runga I tēnei tino a tāhua rā mo te whānau katoa e noho ana I runga I tēnei whenua o Aotearoa. Mai I te marae o arai tūru, kei konei kei o te puti, me mihi ka tika ki a tātou katoa. Ko waiau e tūana kei mua I a koutou, ko te uri no ngā puhi ahau. No reira, tēnei te mihi, tēnei te mihi, tēnei te mihi tu nunui ki a tātou. Tuarua, ko tēnei he tono ki a koutou. Ki te haramai, ki te marae o ārai tūru I a rā, ki te ako I te reo Māori. Ki te ako I te tikanga o te iwi Māori. Me pēhea e haramai ana koutou, me pēhea te āhua he hono tahi tātou I runga I tēnei whenua. Kia ora everybody, on behalf of Arai Tūru Marae, I just want to send out greetings and blessings to everybody that has gathered here to celebrate this beautiful day of Waitangi. I also want to put out to you whānau and a tono, an invitation to come along and learn te reo Māori. If you're interested in learning te reo Māori, my name's Tania Williams, and you can get hold of Missy, one of your great MCs today, or Harlam, and they can give you my phone number, and you can connect up with me, and you can come along to Arai Tūru Marae, and you can begin to learn our reo and learn about our tikanga. This day today was originally set forth by our ancestors to safeguard the Māori people, to safeguard our lands. It's important that we understand the history that the Tupuna Māori arrived in this whenua in 750 AD. 750 AD. We lived here for 1,000 years without any other people other than our traditional people making their way via waka, he waka eke noa, to this land. We had a lot of different nationalities come in that time and live alongside of us after this 1,000 years of us living here. So that takes us to 1750. That's only 300 years ago, Whānau. All right, it's not a long time ago. We had Abel Tasman come to our whenua, and in 1769, we had Captain Cook turn up. By this 57 years, within 57 years of Captain Cook turning up here, the Crown organisations that sold off the land to our people, our tūpuna, our rangatira were complaining about the loss of land, the blankets that were given to our people with diseases on them. Diseases given to people, my goodness, with the authorities of that time give out diseases to kill off a race? If they did it in that time, would they do it in this time? That's the part that I ask you. But within that time, they had taken our lands. They had brought prostitution, guns, and alcohol to these lands that were never here before. I want us to remember that and why it's so important that the true history of Aotearoa is taught to our children in schools. For without the love of our tupuna, the aroha, the rangi marie, none of you would be here. None of our ancestors would have survived in this land because it wasn't the land that it is today. It was a harsh land that those people came upon back in the 1700s and the 1800s. Yet the people that they found upon that land already had systems of order that were working in place and throughout the country. I acknowledge he waka minenga, the United Confederation of Chiefs, and through the waka minenga grew out the waka putanga, which was the first law of this land, the first paper law of this land, because previous to that, we rolled on L-O-R-E, law, and then it became L-A-W. Anyway, whānau, I just wanted to educate us a little bit about the true history and how blessed we are that our tupuna had so much love that we can all gather here as one people today. Ahakoa kowai, ahakoa no here. No matter in where you come from, no matter who you are, may you enjoy this day in the ahua of peace, in the spirit of peace, and in the spirit of love. Nō reira, I jumped up here, took over, and those that know me know that that's what I do. Nō napu ia hau. I'm going to finish off with the waiata. But if you want to come and learn te reo and tikanga, you come and see me at Araiti Urumarai, or you hit up these MCs today, and they're going to give you my phone number, and we're going to talk, and we're going to grow our community under the wairua of kotahitanga. He waka eke no. We're all on this waka together. And one more shout out for my marae. Thank you, Harlam. Four times this year, Araiti Urumarai will be opening up. We want to bring every culture in. We want you to bring in your culture. Come and talk in your language. Come and share with us your dances, the beauty of who you are, what God has gifted to you and your people in your land. Bring your traditions so that we can all grow closer to each other in a spirit of unity. Nō reira. Can I sing the waiata? Is that all right? Nō reira e te whānau, he waka ike noa. Tēnā tātou katoa. He honore, he kororia, he maunga rongo ki te whenua, he whakaro pai ki ngā tangata katoa. He honore, he honore, he kororia, he maunga rongo ki te whenua, he whakaro pai ki ngā tangata katoa. Ake, ake, amene. This is for you, Harlam.
Alright, whānau. Last band, don't introduce himself. Ngā mihi.
Jason. Not yet, no.
Can I just get a bit of keys, please? Just for soul.
Kia ora, kia ora, whānau. Ngā mihi nui ki a koutou katoa. Ko Mason Kevinu Masina tōku ingoa. This is us. This is our band, Black Star House. We are a bunch of music collectives studying at the University of Otago. We're just here to enjoy today. Look back on what's been and progress further. Hope everyone enjoys. We do advise people to have a dance. Today's a celebration. Why not be happy? But just acknowledge what's happened. Sweet.
Guess I'll.
If you don't know this, this is Don't Forget Your Roots. Old message is to remember who you are, remember your past, remember your family, and why not sing along?
get you up to my friend, yeah. Don't forget your family, yeah. Don't forget you to my friend. The ones who made you, the ones who brought you here. Come on with the hook right for. Come on with the key to find out. Come on with the hook right for.
Bit less of me down there would be awesome. It's just the vocals, keys are fine, thank you.
More guitar the side. Sweet.
Oh yeah, a bit more lead guitar for me as well, please. Thank you.
Sweet. We good? We good to go? Keep it zero?
Yep, no, fair enough.
Alright, sweet. We're gonna do a few originals throughout the set. We'll not push ourselves, because we're a brand new up-and-coming band. We've been together for about 3 months. We've been together for about 3 months, and this is our first public Dunedin event. So it's a pleasure to perform to all of you, especially on this beautiful day. Great Dunedin day. We got lucky. Yeah, and so this one is was written by our guitarist, Finn. This one's called Santa Monica Sundays.
In the Lincoln, nothing comes cheap. I'm two steps behind as the whole world fights for peace. Just a matter of time is the word on the street. Keep on rolling to that soulful beat. Red and blue flashes on the cruiser's roof. Small time dealings, shoulders, part of the proof. Life in the city is a tough one too. So keep on moving away to the infectious groove. Santa Monica Sundays, smell of joints, sound of hymns. It's a struggle for justice, corrupt cops and crack rocks. Together we stand alone, we fall. City looking after us all. No hell or just a dream. The years roll on by, passing with the screech. Still hopeful faces, still a happy heart to reach. But for now, keep on rolling to that sofa bed. Palm trees tall and the waves breaking, washing in Santa Monica. Smell of joints and sound of hymns. It's a struggle for justice, corrupt cops and crack rocks. Together we stand alone, we fall. The city ain't looking after us. Oh, oh, oh.
Santa Monica Sundays, smell of joints and sound of hands. Here's a struggle for justice, corrupt cops and crack rocks. Together we stand alone, we fall. The city blinking after us.
So we're just going to pick up the energy with another original. This one's called Cupid Serum, and this one was written by our bass player, probably one of our first songs that we wrote. Sweet. Hope you guys enjoy.
like you. All right, this one's gonna be a New Zealand classic. This one's just gonna be our rendition. So we're gonna try our best, but this is more to set the vibe. We welcome people to stand up and dance, you know. Kia ora whānau. And why not continue to vibe with us? Sweet. It's a crazy scene. Everybody's got their picture in my magazine. Just like a paparazzi. You wouldn't even ask me, no. No, all you got to do is just show people. Look up, I can't help but spy from my wandering eye. Something beginning with the capital Q. I got the wandering light. Oh, no, 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 no.
when I've got it, when I've got it. Cause all around hours they keep on searching. Oh, I've got it, yes, I've got it. When will this sleep never gonna end? Lost my family, I lost my friend. Faces familiar, far from the same. Come a little closer, let me know your name. Who will step into the light, sweet one?
Alright, we're just gonna bring it down just a bit. This was a personal song I wrote. This one was during the BLM movement last year. Because we all gotta stand together. Stood with my brothers. And I wrote this song, which I took inspiration from personally, and from those movements that I saw. So this one was Understanding Equals Progression. Tells me we won't learn.
swallow my anger. I I'm disgusted by your old ways to keep us locked away. Oh no, but you stand here against us, watching those same old stories repeat, repeat and repeat and repeat. Learn from our past. Will we ever learn to just die? Cause the anger keeps on growing, and something tells me we won't learn. But will we ever learn to just die? Cause the hate seems to hold us here, so the anger keeps on growing, and something tells me we won't know. Something tells me we won't learn. Alright, sweet. We're gonna go back into the group song and try and bring up the energy back up to where it was. This one is our first band song we collectively wrote together. And this is a song called Place I Wanna Be. To the land where I want to be, where the sun is low and the water's high. My vision's blurring, twisting, burning through the seams of where I've been or where I am. So let me in. My mind is tired, but my heart is free. Certainly, I am finally free.
Take me away now. I don't wanna stay, I don't wanna stay. Take me away now. From here, yeah, yeah. Take me anywhere that's far from here, where the sand is warm under endless skies. My thoughts are roaming, wandering aimlessly. They linger through the seams of where I've been. So let me in. My mind is tired, something's calling me. So I'm struggling here, I'm finally free.
Take me away now. I don't wanna stay.
Take me away now.
From here, yeah.
Thank you.
All right. This is this next song is a cover. This song goes back to the kōrero at the beginning of before our set. The song's about Captain Cook, and it's written by Troy Kingi, so let's vibe out.
He was sent find the key
to infiltrate
our offspring. To reign supreme, to reign supreme,
How's everyone doing at the moment? Come on, a little bit more effort than that. Yeah, there we go. So we're going to keep revving up the energy. And this one is... This song's called Joker's Intent. Yeah. Continue to dance with us. So if you feel the need, just stand up, dance. You don't need to dance in the middle. Just dance where you are. Sweet. Let's raise the stakes for today's game. Oh, keep your eyes locked. Your mind focused, or you'll lose it. Which hand will you choose? It's up to you. But be careful of the Joker's intent. And why is that? 'Cause he'll cheat you of your money. He'll rob you of your fortunes. Say goodbye. Yo, honeys, wish your lover good luck. You play these games for your own gain, and while you choose the cards, he just plays with your odds. While his numbers rise, he taunts at your own mistakes. But you were warned, of the Joker's answer. And why is that? 'Cause he'll cheat you of your money. He'll rob you of your fortune. Say goodbye to your honey. Goodbye. Oh, and it was all your fault. You're the only one to blame. And you were warned. He'll cheat you of your money. He'll rob you of your fortune. Say goodbye to your honey. 'Cause I love a goodbye. What's the next one? Alright. Oh, yeah, no. Nah, yeah. you got this one.
Have you, man.
Huh? All right, so this one's another one I wrote, but this one's a little bit more happier. This one's looking at the positives of yourself. The song's called Self-Reflect. I thought, why not write a happy song for once? So I came up with this. This one's for my boy Connell. Self-Reflect. Sweet.
I've been waiting for the world to calm down. I've been waiting for the world to breathe it out. 'Cause we're still lost out here, still not sure where to go. But that's alright. That's okay, 'cause I'm happy where we are. I'm happy who we've become so far. I'm grateful that we've made it this far. We gotta stay strong, so let's learn to self-reflect. Let's learn to self-reflect. Oh no, oh no. We've been too hard on ourselves recently. Shall we take a step back from those weary thoughts? Oh, no, no. Well, let's learn to live and live for love. Why not want that for ourselves? Love your passions, love your family. Learn to love yourself. And just remember these words when you're down. Sing these words out loud. 'Cause I'm happy where I am. I'm happy who I've become so far. I'm grateful that we've made it this far. We gotta stay strong. So let's learn to self-reflect. So let's learn to
song. One more. Emerald Gas? Sweet. So this is our last one. And so we'll end off with an original. This one, yeah, no, this one's just, I think, one of our favorites at the moment. So hope you guys enjoy.
True,
we're currently in the recording process of this song, so this song should hopefully be out soon. So if I haven't told you guys already, follow us on Instagram or Facebook at Black Sail House, Black hyphen Sail, S-A-L-E, House. Just like this young lady has said, come up and dance. This is going to be our last song, so why not? Ground's uneven surfaces. The sky's distracting grace. But nothing compares to that image of you, that beautiful emerald gaze. The mountains never falter. Pleasure to perform to you guys. I'm Mason Kewin Umasina. And it's been an absolute pleasure to perform for you guys on Waitangi Day. It's a beautiful day. And we're gonna we're just gonna We're just going to finish off this song, but it's been a pleasure performing to you guys.
While all these old times change, I promise I will stay. As long as you know that my view of you won't change of you. Of you. Wanna know why? Cause nothing compares to those images of you that beautiful every day.
I'm waiting
by the shore.
I'm waiting.
I'm watching from the window high.
Kia ora koutou, ngā mihi nui, kia koutou katoa. It's been a blessing. More? Are we allowed to do one more?
Give it all cool, Bert. All cool, all cool, all cool. One more.
Where's Vicky?
Kay here, Vicky.
Just go for it, bro. Just go for it.
What are we doing?
Go for it.
Rolly.
Just go for it, boys.
What do you want? Up to you.
I don't want to do
that. You're the front one.
I
hear rocket ship's a good one.
All right, let's.
Oh, so that's me, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh,
all right, but we get to do one more, so we're just gonna keep jamming. Let's go.
Yeah. Come on.
All right, we're going to dub this up a little bit. Get your 1-2 steps up. Andrew, I see you over there. Do your 1-2 step. Woo! Let's stick it up.
Show me what is real.
give it up again for our amazing musicians, Finn Kite, Samuel Leeper, Josh Stormer, Soul Wire, and myself, Mason. Again, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much. We've been Black Sour House. Give us a follow on social medias. Kia ora, kia ora.
I'll make the peaky pucky pucky. I know Whānau. Give them another round of applause. I mean, jeez. They did an encore and everything. So, man, maybe he has to kia koutou. Koutou e whakamani manmanani a tātou, a tātou anō. Hey, just as we're about to close off for the day, just want to acknowledge each and every one of you for coming out and celebrating Waitangi Day. Remember, mahara whānau, remember, Waitangi Day is not just for one day. Every day is Waitangi Day, eh? We must always fight for the freedom of our people, and we must also fight for the freedom within ourselves so that we may go into this journey that we call, you know, life as a people and not as an individual. Kia ko tahi te rākau, ara ka whati. Kia ko paihirehia ngā rākau katoa, e kore e whati. So if we were to stand as one reed, we will all break, you know, individually. But if we stand together, if we were to combine together, there's nothing in this world that could break us. So remember that whānau as you go out there and you think about tomorrow, and you think about next week, and you think about your studies and that. What is your legacy you're going to leave on the surf? Is it going to be positive or is it going to be negative? So just think about that as you go through your life. So ngā mihi nui ki a koutou katoa, mā te runga rawa e manaaki e tiaki a koutou katoa, i rungatua i tōna ringa aroha, hei poipoia, ngā moimoia i a koutou, i rungi a koutou. Nō reira, tūtau mai runga, tūtau mai raro, tūtau mai roto, tūtau mai waho ki a tau, te mauri tū, te mauri ora ki a tate katoa. Tūturu fitu whakamaua ki a tēnā. Haumi e, hui e, tai ki e, ngā mihi nui whānau. Whakahau mai ana, ko koe tōku ahine.